Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be painting the passenger side front door on the Charger. And as you guys saw in the last video, I got the whole body of the car ready to seal. So I want to paint that door because it's off and I want to get all the doors painted, but I only have one stand to paint one door at a time. And I still haven't sanded the driver's side in 320 yet. The reason I'm doing that and waiting is so it can shrink back and I don't have to worry about these scratches. It shouldn't really be an issue since I heat lamped it twice, but I don't wanna have any issues later on down the road. So what I have in the paint booth right now is I have the passenger front door and we have the wing. So what I'm gonna be doing, I do have this stand right here, I only have one, but the issue with it, and I could paint the whole door at one time, but what I'm gonna end up doing is actually painting the front and pretty much wrapping it around, but I'm not gonna paint the whole thing. I'll let it cure for a couple days, then I'll paint the backside. The reason I'm doing that, I know it's OCD, you guys are gonna say that, but you can't paint where these are at because it won't work. There's gonna be missed spots and I really don't want that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna paint this, wrap it around to about here. Then when I paint the backside where the door panel and everything goes, I'll just scuff this and then bring the clear up to that spot. I'll just back mask it and you know, it'll look perfectly fine. And a good tip for doing the front before I did the back. So if I did paint this back part first and then I wrapped the clear over it, if I had, since I am gonna clear bra it, even though this is so far back, they'd never bring clear bra this far back. If they peel the clear bra on that edge, the clear edge is right here. So it'd peel that clear up. Maybe, it might peel it up. It's like a 50-50. So doing it this way, the clear's coming this way, and when you're peeling this way, it's not gonna lift the clear. It's a little good tip, but the door, the booth is ready. The door has been waxing greased, so has the wing. So all I have to do is paint the top of this wing, then we'll be able to get these things in production, which I'm really happy about. So let's get mixing paint and getting this stuff painted. I can't wait to see the top of this wing done. I can't actually wait to see how smooth this door is gonna be. I love brand new paint stuff. And another reason I use this stand was so I could paint the door pretty much how it sits on the car. So let's get some base on these things. Yesterday I painted the door and the wing that I made. So The wing looks awesome. This is gonna go off to Black Ops Auto Works. They're gonna make reproductions in carbon fiber and fiberglass. So these are gonna be available in the next coming months. And I think this wing, it looks just, it's aggressive, but it's not too aggressive. So, I mean, I just love how it looks. I love how it looks when you look from the side, down the side, from the back. I mean, it is just the cherry on top for this project. So I'm gonna get another one of these back out of the same carbon fiber I'm making the roof out of. So the carbon fiber and blue Kevlar, but I also added the Trackhawk rear third brake light opening, and it will have a provision for the windshield, the rear windshield squirter, but I'm not gonna use that. And it should work with the rear windshield wiper. So the people that wanna retain that will be able to, and it fits perfect. So that's really nice that that's done. The door, like I said before, I was not gonna paint the back of it because I'm gonna lay it down and then I'm gonna paint this off of the stand because I couldn't get all the way around that. But I really like how this came out. You know, I brought the clear all the way up to where that seal goes. So I'm gonna actually just probably scuff this area right here and then paint where the door panel goes, and then we'll be 100% painted. It's just a little bit of extra work, but I'd rather have everything nice and painted when you pull the door panel off than, you know, when people pull their door panels off, it's like, looks like this. So that came out really nice. The front of the door, a lot of people were saying, Dave, why are you taking so much time to get this door done and get the bodywork done? I mean, when you want stuff to look like glass, look at that. I mean, look at that reflection. So the extra time is well worth it. So the rest of the car should look like that. What I'm gonna do now is pull this rear door off. I'm going to weld the inside of this, and then I need to weld the inside somewhere around here. And then I'm gonna seal that door, get it ready for paint. So I need to seal that. I'm gonna also paint the hinges off the car because I will have to realign the doors anyway. And so on. So let's get to work on getting this door ready to paint, because when I paint the front of this door, I'm gonna paint the back of that door. So just finished sealing the passenger rear door as well as the mirror cap, And I'm really happy to have this front door painted and this rear door ready to be painted. So what I'm gonna do tomorrow is heat lamp that rear door and the mirror cap, then sand them with 600 grit, and then I can get them ready to paint. Just finished getting the front door ready and the back door ready to paint. So I ended up masking all this off. The whole front is actually masked off with paper. Actually, it peeled it back, so I need to make sure that's gonna be okay because I don't want to overspray getting all that nice fresh paint on the door. And what I'm gonna do is actually just paint this whole thing. So what I did was I back masked this, and what that does is actually leaves a nice soft edge because it has that tape rolled. And as you can see right here, that will leave a hard edge, but everything's scuffed, ready to go there. And the same thing with the back door. And then I actually went and masked this off because I didn't want any air blowing in there. The front door, I did that, but I have all these holes. There's a lot more holes on this door than the front door, so I don't want any dust getting kicked up and you know, getting into the air, because then that technically would get back into the paint, which is a bad thing. So what I'm gonna do is wax and grease these, put them in the booth, and then paint the backside, paint the front side. Finished painting the rear door and the back of the front door, and I did end up getting a paint suit. So this was the first time I've ever used a paint suit, and I must say, for clearing, it is probably the best thing that you can do. I just never ordered one, and it's nice when you get done painting, you don't feel like you're a piece of tape. Also throw a link in the description for the paint suit, because it is definitely something, if you're gonna start painting, I would recommend it, as well as I'll throw a link in the description for the mask. So I have an older version of the 3M face mask, then I have the newer version. Both of them are just as good. I've seen a lot of people saying that these ones give you better visibility, but I've used both of them. They're both just as good. I have the pretty intense filters on there. They're like filter out chlorine gas. So, you know, this is just an extra step of protection, especially when you're clearing. It's pretty, you know, the chemicals are pretty bad. So I got both doors all buttoned up, as well as the hinges. I think they both came out. Well, the back of the one door really doesn't matter, but it came out really nice. And then the front of the other door looks just as good as the front of the other door. So I'm just really happy with how this stuff's coming out. I mean, the more I paint, the better I get. And all that bodywork everybody was talking about, and hey Dave, why are you spending so much time on the bodywork? Why is this project taking so long? That looks like a piece of glass, and so does the front door, and so will the rest of the car. So I'm really happy with how this is coming out. So we have the hinges good to go, the bolts for the hinges, and everything is pretty much good. So yeah, the front door, I painted the back, I really didn't show that, but yeah, just pretty much just masked it, back masked it, and then just laid on a nice, I just dusted in some base, then cleared the whole thing. So it should be 100% good to go. And now I won't have to worry about when they clear bra it, anything peeling up with how I painted it. Unless they pull, well, I scuffed it really well. That's one positive. But even if they pull this way, if you're pulling, like I said, if you're pulling the clear bra back off this way, the clear is going that way. So this top layer clear is actually wrapped under the bottom layer clear. It's how I've always done it, and it always seems to work very well. Plus, I prep my stuff pretty well, I think. I mean, I try to get everything scuffed as long as it's nice and dull. That's really what you want to see, because if it's still shiny, you may have issues with, you know, paint lifting, or if you have a sticker on there and you peel it off, as you've seen people that wrap their cars, they have like a big chunk of clear come off. That's what's happening. So I'm gonna end the video here. Really happy that that side of the doors is painted. I left the car outside all day. It was 67, I think, today, and this side seemed pretty hot. So we'll get this all blocked out in the next video. And then also I'm gonna start working on the interior. So I have all the stuff that I need to get the interior done, and pretty much just need to dry all the sound deadening out of there and prep it and then spray it in there. And then we'll be ready to paint the outside of the body, which I can't wait to see it. So I'm gonna end the video here. If you like these videos, make sure you click the subscribe button, thumbs up, throw a comment below. As always, see you guys next time.